In the last video, we talked about functions in general. Now we're going to talk about a very special kind of function, a linear function. But before we do that, let's revisit the second pillar of calculus, track the changes. If I give you any old function, a really important question is, what happens to that function when you change the input a little bit? How sensitive is the function to the input? So if we have some function y equals f of x, and we have some starting point x naught, and y naught is f of x naught, we can say, what happens if we pick a nearby point, x1? That's going to give me a different point. Y1 is f of x1. So this up here we have y1. And we can ask, how far across did we go? We call that distance delta x. How far up did we go? We call that distance delta y. Now sometimes we call delta y the rise. Sometimes you call delta x the run. See, we use the Greek letter delta to mean the change in anything. So delta x is the change in x, how much x has changed when going from x0 to x1. Delta y is the change in y. We're always tracking the changes. Okay? Now, we say that a function is linear if delta y is proportional to delta x. If you change x a little bit, you change y a little bit. You change x twice that much, you change y twice that much. You change x three times as much as before, you change y three times as much as before. In that case, you can write delta y is a constant, which we'll call m, times delta x. And how do you figure out what m is? Well, you pick your other point and you say y1 minus y0 has to be m times x1 minus x0, so m has to be the ratio of delta y to delta x. And that's called the interpolation formula. Now, this isn't just true at this one point x1, it's true over here, it's true over here, it's true over here, it's true at every point. It's true at a general point x and the corresponding point y. So no matter where you are on this, on the graph of this function, the change in the output, y minus y0, has to be m times the change in the input. And this is called the point slope formula. It gives you y as a function of x. So we put the y naught on the other side, and we get y is y naught plus, expand this out, mx minus mx naught. Or that's mx plus y naught minus mx naught. That's just some number. We'll call it b. And this is slope-intercept form. This is the form you've probably seen for the equation of a line. Y is mx plus b. Okay, so here's our picture. We started at x naught, y naught. If we graph the function, for every run delta x, we get a rise delta y. And the ratio delta y over delta x is always m. So the line is y equals mx plus b. So you should think of m in three ways. One is it's a rate of change. It's how sensitive is the function to changes in x. If you're continually increasing x, how fast is f of x changing? The second is it's the slope of this line. Whenever you have a line, the rise over the run is called the slope, and m is delta y over delta x. And the third thing is it's a conversion factor between delta y and delta x. If I give you delta x, you can figure out delta y by multiplying by m. If I give you delta x, you can figure delta y, you can figure out delta x by dividing by m. For example, let's suppose you're driving down the road at 60 miles an hour. X is going to be our input, which is the time. Y is our output, which is our position. And I claim that our position is a linear function of time. If x naught is our starting time, y naught is our starting location. So y minus y naught is how far we've traveled. And that's 60 miles an hour times how long we've been driving. So it's 60 times x minus x naught. So here we have our equation in a point slope form. Y minus naught is 60 x minus x naught. But 60 miles an hour is also a conversion factor. It says you go 1 mile a minute. If you're 10 miles from town and somebody asks you, how far are you? You might say, we're 10 miles away. You might also say, we're 10 minutes away, because you automatically do this conversion between distance and time using the 60 miles an hour as your conversion factor. If you were doing 30 miles an hour and you were 10 miles away, you'd say you were 20 minutes away, because the change in time is the change in distance divided by m. If m is 60, a mile is a minute. If m is 30, a mile is 2 minutes. And if you graphed where you were as a function of time, maybe you were at mile 100 at 1 o'clock, maybe you were at mile 280 at 4 o'clock, and it would be a straight line, which doesn't look like a straight line because I can't draw very well, and the slope is 60. So slope equals conversion factor equals rate of change.